So, another video for me, Jonas Andersson. Today we actually gonna tie elver fly. This really, really effective for the sea trout. I like it. It's a nice simple pattern. Feathers most from the Vulturine Unifo. It's lovely stuff. Bright colors. Yeah, I like it. So, yeah, let's continue. I'm gonna zoom in for the tying part and see you guys after the fly is done. Okay, so for this fly, shows a 3-0 hook. I wanted to be quite large. So, I attached the thread. So the first step would be to add some oval tinsel. In this case I'm using Vivus, extra small. Let me see. Put it back properly. It's not fun when they unwind each other itself. So just tying in the tinsel a little bit. There we are. Then I need a tool. It turns. I think I go with one more. There we are. So going back with the thread. So just tying it in properly. The dog is snoring. Always. There we are. So I'm just going to cut it off there. Let me see. So I'm just going to make a little bit of foundation. Whoops. The thread. Jumping ahead here because I'm going to tie in a silk, two strands of golden silk. I'm going to use it just to build some body since it's a bit thicker. So winding backwards. That part I'm gonna leave out, moving forward. We will see why later. running out of thread. So, tying it in. That one I can level with the black. I can actually tuck it in underneath as well. Just to use the volume. I think you're gonna move this one a little bit. Cutting the silk. I'm not sure if we have a good focus there, I don't think so. Yeah, it's okay. So, moving backwards. So we need to have oval tinsel. This time I used the large videos as well. Just unwrapping the tinsel a little bit to make a nicer tie-in point, maxing the thread. And just tying in the material. And as you see, that levels out. So that's why I didn't add too much. So now I can add a little bit more with the thread. And there we are. So some backs again, just to make sure the silk stays properly. And then I'm gonna use a black silk, so the focus is not that good today. Sorry for that. So let me dig into my piles of material. Here we have black. I'm gonna use my gloves to make sure I don't destroy the shine of the silk. Tying it in properly. Soon it's time for the monster gloves. Okay, so let's work with the silk then. So same as always, close wraps backwards and then back again. Nothing strange. So, almost there. Time to move forward. Starting to get a nice body for the fly. And there we are. So just tie it in. Few wraps. Secure it properly. Remove my gloves. Cutting the leftover silk. Maxing the thread. A few reps more. Then we have this one. This large oval tinsel. Tying it in there. Cutting it off. flexing the thread again. Now we have these feathers. As you can see, really nice shine on them. Natural color. Just gonna bend it a little bit. Same on the other side. Let me see if even, not really. So, tying in the wing here. A bit. So I'm gonna add a little bit of varnish. Just to make sure it stays the way I want it. Varnish, I use the normal vineyard varnish. Now you start to see the color. So let's add the jungle cooked feathers, one on each side of course. So I'm just adding my side first, there we go. Perfect. Some more legs. Little bit of varnish. Just to make sure they actually gonna stay there when you fish the fly. Okay. So time to cut off the leftovers. Focus. There we are. And then we have this feather. It's also from the Guinea, Ultra Guinea Full. One of the rare ones. Almost everything is blue. So I'm going to use it as a front hackle. So gently push it backwards. Okay. Securing the thread properly. And then cut the leftovers. Now I'm just going to build up a little bit of a head. Now you're just using the white thread, since the head is supposed to be red. I'm going to use red varnish from Vanyard to color the head. That's sufficient, not too much. So I start with clear. There's a reason for it. When you first add the clear varnish, I let it dry for a little bit and then add the colored varnish you want, then most of the time the colored varnish doesn't get sucked into the wing or the hackle. So that was the clear varnish. Just going to let it dry for a little while. So now the last part. Just add the red varnish. Then you add haven't used it so many years, but it should be fine. So, the elver fly is basically done, and that's how you do it. So, please press the thumbs up and comment or share the video, and make sure you subscribe to the channel. You can have an icon here, and also I'm going to add a playlist over here with other flies I tied. So, thanks a lot for watching, and see you in the next video. And that video is going to be the Green Highlander, and I'm going to start it tomorrow, part 1 of 2. Okay, see you.